We're going to have so much fun tonight at our Christmas party. My name is Elsa, and this is my sister,
Anna.
We came here from Arendelle. We wanted to start off the Christmas party with you guys. Thank you so much for coming. We're just going to have such a great time. I thought that we would start by singing one of our favorite Christmas songs from Arendelle, Ringing in the Season. Is that something fun?
Everyone that'll realize we plan a party as a big surprise. Soon the ballroom will echo with sounds of cheer as we ring in the season this year. This is overdue, gotta look our best.
Ooh, I've never been so nicely dressed.
We'll be hosting and toasting the whole night through as we're ringing the season with you. It's the first Christmas in forever since we opened up the gate. And it's the first Christmas I remember to date, and it's already worth the wait.
Today, friends. Does that sound like fun? We're going to sit down here, and if you want to come up and see the pictures, you can come make a circle around here. But Anna will hold up the pages so you can see the pictures anyway. This is a very special story that we brought all the way from Arendelle. It's one of our favorites, isn't it? It's called Family Matters. All right, so here we have, do you know who that is? Who's that little snowman? Do you know him? He's one of our best friends. His name is, do you know?
Olaf.
He's looking at a picture of me and my sister. It says, as Olaf walked through the castle, he noticed a portrait of Queen Elsa and her sister Anna. That's us. The painting made him happy because he liked the sisters so much. He's just the sweetest. Just then, Olaf heard Elsa's voice. Maybe the ballroom, she said. The ballroom's too big, Anna replied. How about the courtyard? Olaf stared at the image in awe. Wow, this painting is so realistic, he explained. Do you know what that means, in awe? It means he thought it was so wonderful. Oh, here we are, and Olaf is coming in to see us. Let's see what it says. The courtyard doesn't seem right either, Elsa continued. Suddenly, Olaf realized the voices weren't coming from the portrait, but from the study at the end of the hall. He thought the picture was talking to him. He's so funny. What are you doing? He asked. We're planning a party, Elsa explained. I love parties, Olaf exclaimed. At that moment, Gerda and Kai entered the study. Good morning, Gerda said. I've got some new flowers for you, and I have your hot chocolate, Kai chimed in. Anna quickly pulled Olaf aside. It's a surprise party, she whispered, so you have to keep it a secret. I love secrets, Olaf whispered as Kai and Gerda left the room. Do you think Olaf can keep a secret? Let's find out. Elsa had an idea. Olaf, would you like to gather supplies for the party? The little snowman's eyes lit up. Really? Elsa handed him a list. "Ooh," said Olaf, "these must be secret ingredients. You can count on me." And before the sisters could read the list to him, Olaf raced outside and bumped right into Kristoff. Ooh. There's Kristoff. Oh, and Sven. Do you know Sven? He's our reindeer friend. "Hi," Olaf said. "I'm helping with the surprise party." Kristoff grinned. "You mean the one for..." But Olaf shushed Kristoff. "Even my list is a secret." "Really?" asked Kristoff. "Yes, so secret, even I don't know what it says." "See?" Kristoff laughed. "That's because you can't read," he said. "Let me help." Olaf is so funny. Kristoff read the list to Olaf and Sven. In no time, the snowman and the reindeer were off to find the supplies. The first item was goat cheese. When Olaf and Sven pulled up to the Anderson family goat farm, Marty and Gorin welcomed them warmly. Look at, they're saying hello. Those are good friends of ours. Gorin looked at Olaf's list. "A party, huh? Our cheese wheels are a perfect party snack." "What are cheese wheels?" asked Olaf. "It's how we store cheese," explained Gorin. "We tried rectangles. It was a disaster." Some of the Andersons' kids helped load the cheese onto the wagon. Olaf and Sven thanked them and headed to their next stop, the Miller Family Flour Mill. Let's see what they have there. When the wagon halted in front of the windmill, a young girl greeted them. "Hi, I'm Laura." Oh, look, they're giving a warm hug. Olaf just loves warm hugs. "Hi, I'm Olaf. I like warm hugs," Olaf said. Nora was happy to give him one. "Aw, that's so nice. Is your windmill haunted?" Olaf asked when he saw a shadowy figure. "No, that's a ghost." "That's no ghost," Nora laughed. "That's Uncle Lassie. He's just covered in flour." "Flour isn't just in our family," Nora explained. "It's in our clothes, too." "See, they work with flour, and it just gets all over them. Do you ever help Mummy bake? Do cookies or cake? You get flour, it just gets everywhere." Olaf showed them his list. Uncle Lassie quickly fetched a few sacks of flour, and put them in the wagon. "Your party sounds like fun," he said. "And here's plenty of flour to bake a cake big enough to feed the entire castle." "I didn't know castles could eat," said Olaf, waving goodbye. Olaf and Sven had one last item to get. Flowers from the nursery run by two sisters, Violet and Vita. Can't have a party without flowers. Olaf showed the sisters his list, and Violet quickly rolled up a wheelbarrow full of different flowers. "This garden's been in our family for generations," said Violet. "You're a family too?" asked Olaf. "Do you have goats or ghosts?" Vita smiled. "Families are like snowflakes. They are hard to catch on your tongue," Olaf interrupted. "And no two are exactly alike," Vita said. When the snowman returned to the castle, he was greeted by Anna, Elsa, and Kristoff. "I have all the secret ingredients," said Olaf. "Great work, Olaf," Anna said. Then she began pulling the petals off the flowers. Kristoff carried the flour toward the castle, and Elsa whisked away a plateful of cheese wheels. "See you at the party," she told Olaf. "Don't forget, it's in the library." Party at the library. But when Olaf arrived at the library, he saw only Elsa, Anna, Kristoff, and Sven. "Where is everyone else?" he asked. "This party's for our family," Elsa said, "and the guests of honor are about to arrive." At that moment, Gerda and Kai entered. Elsa and Anna threw the colorful flower petals into the air and shouted, "Surprise!" Gerda and Kai were speechless. They were so surprised by the surprise party. Can I see your surprised faces? Go. "Let's see. You've been family to us ever since I can remember," Elsa said with a smile. "We wanted to say thank you." "You did all of this for us?" Gerda asked. Elsa said, "We wanted to do something nice for you." Kai looked into his cup, which was filled with delicious frozen chocolate. "I can tell you made it," he said. "I like to eat everything frozen." We added a little vinegar and salt to the flour Olaf brought us, and Anna and I used it to polish all the brass and copper in the kitchen, said Kristoff. Olaf turned to Anna, and you made the flowers into colorful snow? Yes, said Anna, it's called confetti. said Olaf, so what is the cheese for? To eat, of course, said Kai, as he took a big bite. It's my favorite. Does anyone here like to eat cheese? No, you don't like it? Do you like cheese? Is that yummy? Yeah. This is a different kind of party, said Olaf. Anna chuckled. Well, we're a different kind of family. Yeah, different, said Olaf. Just like everyone else. Oh, we had so much fun that day, didn't we, Anna? That was such a great party with all of our family. Do you guys like to have parties with your families? Yeah, that's really nice. Well, now that we're done with our story, I thought we should do some dancing here at our Christmas party. Do you guys like to dance? Who likes to dance? Yeah? Okay, I was thinking we would dance to my favorite song. Do you know what my favorite song is? It's called Let It Go. Do you know that one? Should we dance to Let It Go? Let's stand up and practice the moves. Can everyone stand up on their feet? Good job, you're ready to go. Nice, awesome. Okay, so in the beginning of the song, you might remember, I was feeling kind of sad. So when you're sad, you kind of have your head down and you're looking at the ground. Okay, so you can be sad. Good, we have to do some acting. We're gonna start the dance. We're gonna hold ourselves like it's really cold and rock side to side really slowly. Can you do that? Great job. And then we're gonna walk sad. Can you walk in a small circle with your head down? Great. Ooh, very nice. Very dramatic. All right, we have to practice our ice powers. Are you ready? So let's do one hand out. Make your ice. Great. And then your other hand. Nice. Can we swirl it around like you're making a snowman? Make your own snowman. Great. Then lift it up. Great. And drop it down. Wow, you guys have magic ice powers too, don't you? Oh my goodness, really great. Okay, that's so good. Now let's see, can you do snowflake hands? Let's see, big hands way up high. Wow, good job. Bring them up high and float them down to the ground. All the way down. Great. And then the wind comes, blows them away. Awesome, really good. Okay, now, this is where the song starts to get a little happier, when I build up my ice castle. Have you guys seen my ice castle? I'm really proud of it. Let's try to make our own ice castle. Ready? We'll bring our hands down to the ground, and we're going to bring it up. It's kind of heavy, so you have to go slow. Bring it all the way up. It's really big. Awesome. Good job. That was amazing. Okay, are we ready to try it with the song? What do you think? Yeah? Yay! Okay. So remember, when the song is just starting, I'm feeling kind of sad. Can you guys show me your sad face? Look down, kind of heavy, yeah. Alrighty. And you can sing along too. All right, head looking down. So sad, good job. Alright, here we go, ready? Let's
go.
Storm rage on.
to test the limits and break the rules.
Want to play a game? Yeah? Perfect. That's perfect. Okay. So in this game, we are going to move around like snowflakes. Where we come, it does snow a lot. Kind of my fault, but we like that, right? So we're going to dance around like snowflakes. How do you think a snowflake would move? How does a snowflake move? Does a snowflake move down kind of fast? Or does it come down kind of slow usually? Usually kind of slow and graceful, right? Yeah, sometimes they move side to side. Sometimes snowflakes like to twirl. We like to twirl, don't we? Do you like to twirl? So we're gonna move around like snowflakes. And when the song says snowflakes touch the ground, we're gonna float all the way down to the ground. And then the wind's gonna come, just like in our last dance, and blow us away. Yes, and then we dance around like snowflakes again. Okay, do you think you got it? Yeah, are you ready to try it? All right, let's start standing up on our feet. Great, let's practice some snowflake moves first. Ready? How about let's sway side to side with our arms. Can I see side to side? Beautiful, wow. Really good. Okay, how about our snowflake hands? We know that one. Very nice. Okay, how about some spins? Can I see your twirls? Twirl around. Wow, good. Very lovely. All right, let's practice floating down to the ground before we start the game. Ready? Let's do snowflakes up high and bring it all the way down. Good, and then the wind comes. Ready? Show me how you blow away in the wind. Beautiful, wow. I love that. Didn't they look beautiful, Anna? So beautiful. Okay, I think we're ready to start the game. Everybody up on your feet. We'll listen for the song. You can do any snowflake moves you want to. We can do our twirling or rocking side to side, our snowflake hands. We'll just listen for when the song says snowflakes touch the ground. And then we touch the ground. Here we go, ready? Dance like a snowflake.
Snowflakes, snowflakes, dance around. Snowflakes, snowflakes,
touch the
ground. Snowflakes,
snowflakes,
right in the air. Snowflakes, snowflakes, everywhere. Snowflakes, snowflakes, dance around. Snowflakes, snowflakes, touch the ground.
Here comes the wind, ready? Fly it. Wow, good.
Snowflakes dance around.
Nice.
Snowflakes, snowflakes touch the ground.
Great.
Snowflakes,
ready?
Snowflakes in the air.
Wonderful.
Snowflakes, snowflakes everywhere. Snowflakes, snowflakes.
Really nice dancing, you guys. You guys are so talented. Lovely.
Thank you.
Some kids have tried to catch him, but Santa's fast, you see. So they've set their eyes on a smaller prize, and now they're after me. Uh-oh. I'm not my friend upon a shelf who comes each year and sits. No, I've got grace. I'm the elf that never quits. Do you have elves that sit on your shelves? Anybody have an elf on the shelf? Those ones you can't catch, right? You can't touch them because of their magic. Us, some people like to catch us. Now Santa's ready to go. I'm sure your traps are scary. I'll do my best to dodge them all and leave you feeling merry. In I go to Emma's house to make sure all is clear. A tinsel net? Oh, that's just fun. I won't get caught in here. Let's see what other traps they try to set for the elf. Jaden's trap cannot be missed. I think it's double-sided. He's got his spot on my naughty list. You bet that's been decided. Anybody in here on the naughty list? I hope not. You guys are on the good list, right? The nice list. I'm sure everyone in here looks so nice. Another house is filled with treats. These kids are getting smarter. I can't resist candy canes. My job is getting harder. Santa slowly lowers me into a dangerous room. If I touch down, he won't just frown. There'll be a bonbon boom. Uh-oh. Your Christmas maze is all laid out. My work's no longer cushy. I safely brought you all your gifts, but hey, you zapped my tushy. And now my radar's perking up. The next one's quite a chore. We don't yet know what lies ahead in this family grocery store. We run inside and get caught up in an avalanche of food. We've seen all kinds of traps before, but not to this magnitude. Do you see all that food? So much food falling down to catch the elf. Uh-oh. The dinner cannon burps and spits and shoots out ham and gravy, and then it follows with dessert. Please, Santa, will you save me? We tumble down the waterfall above the eggnog river. But Santa and I are an awesome team. Look at that. Do you see sliding all the way up? Look at Santa go. Together we deliver. And now it's time for us to leave. Our night is nearly done. You tried your best this Christmas Eve, so Merry Christmas, everyone. So now you have some ideas about how to catch an elf. But maybe don't try them, because we don't like that so much. All right. Well, we were thinking that maybe we would share with some of our dance moves. Elves love dance parties, don't we? Do you guys like to dance? Who likes to dance? Yay, not you. Uh-oh. You like to dance? Good. You do too? Awesome. Can I teach you some moves that we like to do at the North Pole? Why don't we stand up on our feet? We'll try them out. All right. Here are some of our favorite dance moves. Hello. That we like to do. We like to do slides, so we pretend we're on ice, and we have our ice skates on, and we're going to slide from side to side. Ready? Can you drag your feet and slide like you're ice skating? Slide. Good. Swing your arms side to side. Awesome. Great job. All right. And then we like to pretend we're kicking the snow way up in the sky. Kick. Nice. Your big kick, your highest kick. Look at that. Nice. Very good. Of course, we like twirls. Very nice, I love it. And jumping, of course. The elf love jumping. Woo, very good. All right, and then here's a tricky one. We do heel to the side, and together. Great, heel to the side, and together. Awesome, that's not too tricky, but now we're gonna add a jump to it. Can you jump and put your heel up, and jump together, jump out, together. And together, good job. Up and together. Fancy, I love it. Okay, so we have a game that we love to play at the North Pole. It's called the freeze game. Do you guys know how to play the freeze game? Yeah? So when play at school,
Oh my goodness, that sounds like so much fun. When the music comes on, we're gonna dance. We're gonna do some of the moves that we just practiced. And you can do some of your own moves too. And then when the music stops, what do you think we do? Freeze, don't move, that's right. And when we freeze, we're gonna try doing poses. So let's practice poses, ready? Any pose you want, on the count of three. One, two, three, freeze. Nice, one, two, three, freeze. So good, one, two, three, freeze. Awesome poses, I love it. All right, are we ready to dance? Yeah, who has the music? Here we go.
March and march.
So, you know our names. My name is Jolly, and my friend Tinsel. What are your names? On the count of three, I want you all to shout your names all at the same time. Are you ready?